Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back to Flint Hills. It is winter time, and we're just now getting to tillage. As always, over 67% of you are not subscribed, so if you want to help a pickle out, then click that subscribe button to join the Pickle Jar community. So as you guys can see, we have well and finished harvest, and in good time. As you see, some of the crop that got left right there has withered now because it did snow just the other day. And that means that the ground might be a little bit too cold for fall tillage, but I think it's just warm enough out that we can get this done. But it might not be, and if that's the case and the ground is actually frozen, then we're gonna be in a world of hurt, and that means we're gonna have to do all of the tillage this spring. But honestly, that's not necessarily a bad thing. That means the ground doesn't get turned over right now and doesn't sit more exposed throughout the winter, which will actually help with the soil preservation. But if that's the case and we can't get to fall tillage here in winter, then I guess we're just gonna have to find some other things to work on. And trust me that there's plenty to go around on the farm. I think the first thing that I want to do is get all of this equipment kind of put away. It's been out here in a bit of a mess recently. This old truck we did not end up using, so we're going to just fire it up. Hopefully it'll start, and it did. And let's just put this back in the shed over here where it belongs. We might also mow up the ditches as well, just so they are nice and taken care of. And yeah, our yard probably needs mowed too, but hey, why not? So we're also going to bring the 8400 in. Now this one's actually still got a little crop in the back of it, so I guess we can go dump this, take it on back to the farm, and then we'll end up using it for the fall tillage here today. All right, we're unloading the last of the crop into this deal right here, as you can see. And let's get back on over to the farm, shall we? As you guys can see, Grant has gotten most of his field harvested and even tilled over. He's been working hard on that, gotten quite a bit done here so far. He did leave a grain cart out in the field, though. That's kind of strange. I don't know. Maybe it broke down or something. Maybe it broke a tire. I don't know, man. But it's there. I guess maybe we could steal it. You think Grant would notice? Oh, and if you guys haven't heard, Austin's now our neighbor. I think he bought that place right there. Maybe he didn't buy that one, but I think that's the place he bought. All right, we're back at the farm. We're going to pull on in here, put these grain carts away, connect up to our ripper, and see if we can't get to going on fall tillage here. All right, so what I want to do is try and pull this right up here like so, and then pull right on past it. Perfect. Pull this right off over here. That'll do. Leave it run. Top back in the 40, 50, the 45th, 4, what? 4450. Ay, ay, ay. Numbers are hard, man. Numbers are hard. Okay, now we're going to back right up if we can. Here we go. There we go. There we go. And now we have both connected together, so we can just pull this right on through and park them back where we keep them in storage, which is right over here. And right there will do. Now we can pull this out of the way. Actually, that baler has been sitting there for like 10 and a half years. We should probably move that. There we go. Baler's been moved. Now we're just going to hop back up in the 8400, run on over here, connect up to, I believe we have a case ripper right over here. And now just back right on up. All right, got the pin in, got the jack up. It's ready to go. Let's hop back up in the 8400. And whoa, Jake. And let's head on out to the field, shall we? So King and I were talking about doing some expansions to the farm. One of the expansions being more pens, pastures, perhaps some more buildings for indoor like storage for winter homes for the horses. And we have a really nice little training track here. I love this track, but we were thinking about building a second one that's a little larger. So we can start them out on this track, and then maybe work their way up to a full mile track or something like that. But those buildings and stuff probably aren't going to be coming this winter. Maybe they will. I'm not entirely sure. They might be better suited for a spring project. But as long as there's not snow on the ground, we could probably get away with doing it. For that expansion, we were talking about moving this way into this portion right over here on our left, where the road passes by. So we don't take out too much more of our field. We can use this area here and build some pastures and buildings and what have you. There's a lot of land right there that's available for expansion. But I don't know if that will be able to fit the new track if we do decide to do that. So we'll see about that when the time comes. All right, let's unfold the disc here. We're going to drop it down as well. Dang it. It's looking like the ground is too frozen. I can't penetrate it very well. Oh, man. That's going to be a problem. We'll just have to leave the ground sit as is with the stubble on it and then come back and clean it up this spring. So I suppose we're just going to return this back to where it belongs, and then I think we'll hop in maybe the 6410 or something along those lines, and maybe we'll do a little bit of mowing just to clean that up for when the snow falls. And right there will do. Let's come to a stop. Let's hop out, disconnect it. All right, that's been disconnected. I don't think we're going to need the 8400 really to mow, but we'll get that figured out when the time comes. For now, we'll use this open cab and just freeze our little tushy off. It is only 34 degrees out today, so I do have the warm clothes on. Although later this winter, when it gets really cold, 34 degrees is going to feel really warm. All right, let me just sneak right on back past that. All right, we got all connected to our mower here. It's a little dirty. It's seen better days. I think we're gonna... It's not quite freezing out yet. It's 34 degrees. No. Okay. Better not. Better wait until it's a little warmer to do that. I was gonna wash it off, but we'd probably be fine, but I just don't want to risk it. We'll just line right up for it. We'll kind of unfold this deal. Let the chains hang down. There we go. Drop it down, and we'll turn her on and pull on through. So we'll just mow up the ditchways here. We might mow all the way up to the fence line. Just mow it real deep, just for winter. Although it's not a bad thing to leave your grass a little long in winter. It can kind of retain that snow, if you will. But along the ditchway here like this, I feel like the state is just going to appreciate it if we mow this down. It'll be easier for them to plow that snow in. But it also means it'll be easier, a little easier for that snow to drift over in these areas. So, you know, yin and yang, I guess. A win and a loss. All right, coming up to a little deal here. We're going to take that nice and easy. Whoa, holy cow, that's a lot more steep than I thought it was. Come on, climb on up out of there. There you go. Come on. Woo, look at that. That is steep, isn't it? All right, try and get it up over there sooner and then hang it back over and around. Oh, we got a tire spinning. There we go. Right on across. Pick it up, the gravel, and just back right on down into the ditch. Put her back down and keep mowing. Now, I've had the co-op truck down on our farm for like half the year now, and I really need to get that back up to the co-op because it's not mine to have on the farm. So I think we're going to run that up to the co-op here real quick as well. All right, we are back returning this tractor. So I'm just going to pull it right on in here. Shouldn't be too much of an issue for now. Right up into the corner should be fine. Shut her down, hop out, run on over. Don't get cut by a blade here. Run on over to that truck and take it up to the co-op. And we will just head, wait a minute. It's getting a little cold. Let's actually close all this up here, shall we? Later this winter, we will be also actually foaling out those horses quite a bit as well. So we're going to have to, we have cameras set up on the foaling barn in there and things like that. And as well as we'll use the vet barn. And come by the end of winter, come springtime, we should have a bunch of new foals on the farm. Oh, would you look at that? There's still some snow sitting over here in this area. I'm just going to pull this truck right on in. That ought to be fun right there. Run on over here, close up this door. And conveniently, we actually have our other truck sitting up here from earlier just the other day. So we're going to fire it up and we are going to take it back on down to the farm. You know, before we head on back to the farm, we might as well take advantage of the fact that we're here in town. And I think I'm going to run on over to Tractor Supply real quick and pick up some road salt for the next time that it snows here. All right, we got a road salt from Tractor Supply. So we're going to get on back down the road. Oh man, somebody went in the ditch right there. That's got to suck. I might be kind today. We might take a little time out of our day to help this snow plow truck get on out of here. The state seemed to have just left it. All right, so what do you guys think? Let's see here. I do have a tow rope with me, a chain. We should be able to connect. Yeah, right back there. Looks like there's a good spot. And this guy just got right off in the ditch and just got her stuck, didn't he? Let's see if we can't get this guy unstuck here. So let's just back right on up. I'm going to angle my rear end off a little bit more, but try not to get into the ditch too much. Too much, too much, too much, too much, too much. Ooh, that was close. All right, let's see how that's looking. That ought to be good. Let's get the chain. All right, we got it chained up. They actually left the truck unlocked, and I was able to make sure I could put it in neutral here, lifted up the plow. Let's see. Let's just give her a little tug, see if we can't get it out of there. Oh, all right, there we go. Let's hop out and see if we got that here. All right, we got the chain off of the truck here. I put the truck back in park. We did get it up out of the ditch for them. So we got that out for the state. I'm sure that they'll appreciate that. They'll be able to come and pick it up finally. And we're going to get back on down to our farm. All right, guys, that is going to do it for this one. We're back at the farm. Got the road salt brought back. Mowed up some ditches. Gonna drive into the ditch if I'm not careful. Man, these brakes suck. Tried to do some fall tillage, but weren't able to. And that is gonna do it for this one. Hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you did, make sure you give it a thumbs up. Thank you all so much for watching. And until next time, I'll see y'all later. Can you picture you and me in the darkness? Kissing, touching.